Off the skate of Voracek, then Sanheim plays it around behind the net. Giroux trying to get away from the checking there. Did punch it along the boards. Couturier back out to Manning. Manning, a wrister. Score! No goal. Voracek was in and around the crease, and it was immediately waved off by the referee. And so instead of a 1-0 lead, a disallowed goal here, although they are going to talk about it.
Petrangelo was in the way also and either picked up the stick of Voracek or possibly could have caught his stick in front as well. Here's the shot by Manning, who's been firing all game. So far, there's the traffic in front.
You can see the push. Contact with the goaltender prior to the goal.
Incidental contact, so
they had a pretty hard to heart about this, Jonesy. Immediately, they went back right in front of the penalty box area and reviewed it. One of the refs was explaining what he saw, so there's some clarity at the end of it. That's a tough call.
And the Flyers do have the ability to challenge this if they choose to.
Yeah, thinking about it, as they look at their monitors and Furlatt over there, they're giving them a little time to make this decision. So Furlatt comes away from the Flyer bench, and I believe they are going to review this.
Philadelphia is challenging the play for goaltender interference.
And so the review will be whether or not Voracek was pushed into the Blues goaltender. It was unavoidable contact or not.
Now remember, this is not that the Flyers will get a penalty if it doesn't go their way. They lose their timeout.
Here's the another look at it here. In the overhead, there's Voracek going into the area. And that is not goaltender interference. So the goalie went out and pushed on him.
He's outside the crease.
He's outside the blue paint. And I think that Allen's argument was the puck was high-sticked. And the referee called a goaltender interference, but I think Dave Hakstol is going to get this one right.
There's another look at it again. Up high and over top. Voracek's outside the paint. Allen comes out, makes a contact. And then Petrangelo ends up pushing Jake back into it.
Petrangelo was the reason Jake was getting close to the crease. He's set up outside the crease.
This, I feel much more confident about this one than the one that went against the Flyers in Ottawa, where Jordan Wheel had actually backed into the blue paint before some of the contact had taken place. We figured that was a 50-50. This one, I think, falls in the Flyers' favor.
Looks like we have a call. Ghislain Hébert will give us the call.
After review, it was determined it was the St. Louis defenseman that pushed the Philadelphia player in the goal. Therefore, the call at the ice is overturned. We got a good goal, Philly.
And the Flyers take a 1-0 lead. Good challenge by the Flyers. And they get the first one here.
Jake stops in front, is not in the blue paint. Allen makes initial contact, and then he's pushed in by the defender. No goaltender interference, a good call, and a good job by the referee to overturn that call.
Really good job by Hakstol and his staff right there getting that right. And we're up against it time-wise. They got it right. Good job.
So 38 seconds into this second period, the Flyers are on the board. Manning had four shots in the first period to lead the Flyers. There's that one in, and the Flyers try to play from the lead. Here is Simmons.